Some might say that the vast expanse of forest that covers the world is the pinnacle of loneliness. A plain of trees stretching as far as your sight will allow. The moisture of the earth coating your nostrils. The silence only breaking for the glimmer of settling leaves. They're wrong. You know they're wrong because you can read the unspoken thoughts of the wood. A being made up of a menagerie of life itself. This is what you're thinking as you wait, patiently perched on a branch, just high enough to be out of the way of prying eyes. The nearest town may be a couple hours away, but it doesn't make the woodland paths deserted. Doesn't mean you should let your guard down enough to be vulnerable. The denizens of this wood don't seem to agree, however. Paw prints tell you a family of minks recently passed through. Scattered holes imply moles have moved in. And a recently plundered berry bush admits that even a black bear has made its way here. That's quite unusual. Bears don't usually traipse so close to civilization. At least, without a purpose. Upon closer inspection, you see tracks surrounding the bush and leading off in the same direction as the others. Well, this should be interesting. Where it had been dusk when you happened upon the berry bush, the sky is now overtaken deep indigo of night. Silver moonlight cascades through slits in the canopy, providing small islands of bright white along the path. The full moon looms overhead. A careful watcher. Your bow grows heavy in your hand. The wood grooves gliding smoothly over the pads of your fingers as you rub against it anxiously. You've been on foot too long for your liking. But your trek in the woods has gotten more and more intriguing. Countless trails of tracks have joined the bears, sketching lines of purpose through the once wild landscape. Whatever they're walking towards, they're just as anxious as you are to get to it. The moon is quickly approaching its apex when you see it. It starts as a mere pinprick, but as you make your way further and further into the tangled nest of trees, the light grows golden. It's as if you've entered another world. The previous blues, blacks, and navies have been replaced by warm golds and a bright white. A large, circular glade opens up before you. The densely packed ferns at its edges providing perfect cover for you to quietly observe what's displayed in front of you. Animals fill the stretch of your vision. Beasts of all shapes, forms, domains form concentric rings that cover the whole of the glade. Foxes are communing with rabbits. Squirrels dine on seeds with salamanders. Even the solitary owls have flown down from their midnight eaves. The festivities are illustrious, but not enough to cut the tension. There's a buzz in the air. It almost seems like the animals are whispering to one another, restlessly looking between the center of the glade and the slowly climbing moon, seemingly waiting for it to reach its peak in the sky. And then it happens. A hush falls over the glade as the moon finally touches the highest point in the sky, directly over the only open patch of grass in the midst of the animals. You look on in awe as a pillar of light forms, illuminating the clearing. and sending the creatures of it into action. It starts with the wolves. A long, lone howl fills the air, breaking only for a deep breath. On the second howl, the coyotes join. On the third, the bobcats. On the fourth, the owls, and so forth, until all of the animals join in a massive chorus. They breathe and bay in unison. If you weren't here to witness it yourself, you would have assumed the forest itself was crying. The harmony between these creatures that usually find themselves in opposition to one another is beautiful. It moves you in a way you can't describe. Human civilization, with its conflict and its politics, was never kind to you. Never felt as unifying as this. That's why you left. Why you exist beyond the borders of towns. It's also why you join them. You inhale, taking in all of the struggles you've faced in your isolated lifestyle. All of the loneliness you felt in the cities of the world. And you release, howling alongside them, as if you're one with the glade. Because you are.